So good evening, everybody. I'm really happy to be here and sharing with you this hour of music. I'm going now to play a piece by Ermanno Montferrari, that was an Italian-German composer that was among the top one in the field of opera in the first part of 20th century. He is really linked with the Verismo opera and really was somebody really important, completely forgotten or almost right now, except for a few pieces. This is one of those. In fact, the two intermezzos and the prayer from his own opera, The Jewels of Madonna, of the Madonna, are among still the most performed pieces in the orchestral way. At that time, in 1911, when this piece came out and the opera came out, it was so successful that a lot of transcriptions were made. And the one I'm going to play of this piece has been done by Wilhelm Middelschütter. That was a great, giant performer, German, living in the States. And it's nice to see in this program of today how many links we have between US and Italy in the field of the organ. So we start now with this piece that is truly symphonic, and I'm sure that you're going to taste these big lines, melodic lines, but with this new flavor that was the one that was having so much success in the beginning of the century. Enjoy. is for sure an unexpected page, this one, and I'm sure that probably has conquered some of you, because really is something. Now we are going to have two bossy pieces. He was a giant in the Italian organ world across the beginning of, I mean, the end of 19th and beginning of 20th century. And he is one that has, in some way, made a revolution in the Italian organ world, composed many, many, many pieces. And unfortunately, only the organ music is the survived one in the whole landscape of his production. Actually, he's linked with the States because he dies while coming back home from a big tour he has in the States, in the transatlantic, during in his way back home. His link is also because he had many students that were in big positions in New York area, as well in other parts of the country. And his production was also published here. I decided to play two pieces. One is really well known, and the other one is the scherzo that actually has been published just a few years ago. It's called Third Movement from a Thematic Symphony. He called it this way, a piece that has to be a symphony but has never been composed. Actually, only this movement is complete. But it is complete in some way. I mean that just the notes are there, so all the indications are almost to be reconstructed in some way, based on other models by other composers of the same kind of form. So we have a ABA form, and this scherzo is quite curious because it's really orchestral and give really the idea that can be orchestrated in some way. The other piece by him, that is the Intermezzo Lirico, is among his most well-known pieces, and is a relaxed mood, like in an opera way also, because it's an intermezzo, an interlude like. So with big lines again, and with a lot of tension growing as a orchestra writing. So enjoy these two pieces that really, I think they really work together. Giuseppe Ferrata was an Italian musician, actually a piano player, was the last piano player, the last piano student by Liszt in Rome. And he was really going to be a big virtuoso. But then, for personal reasons, he left Italy and moved to the US because it was invited to become professor in a college and in a conservatory, but then other things happened. By the way, all his composition output came out in the States, and in the States he gained a position as a respected maestro, but he never became the great piano player that he was expected to be. He won several competitions for compositions, and almost all his works were published in the States. Among his great compositions for organ, I choose this Notturno that is quite a surprise for everybody because it recalls so many of the piano compositions across the century, the end of 19th and beginning of 20th, with some special flavor. I'm sure that also this will be a nice discovery for all of you, and I wish that with this experience, you are going to explore the production of this composer that is completely available for free. So let's have this Notturno. Enjoy. Thank you. I just realized that I haven't played the list that was expected. I anticipated the ferrata, but was a good even idea to do that. In this way, we can have the pupil and then the master. The piece by Liszt, Sposalizio, has been created by him as a piano piece while looking a wonderful fresco that is in Roma. Actually, Liszt himself has done a transcription of this, but his own aesthetical reason, it has become a piece really, really different from the original. And actually, I prefer to perform always this transcription done by Désiré Walter, that was a French organist at the beginning of the 20th century, and that gives more the orchestral idea of the original piece. Indeed, the Liszt one become more and more spiritual. The Walter one keep intact the idea of the piano piece. So these are two different worlds, but I love to share how can be orchestrated the original one. That's why I love so much this transcription by Walter. So enjoy. Here we now with the last piece of the official program. So it is my composition, Vittime Pascali, that was written almost 10 years ago. It's a set, I don't know what to say, of variations. It's more a paraphrase of each verse of the text of the sequence. So we have all the single line that is in some way, how to say, commented by the music. And at the end, we have the added Alleluia of the Easter day, O Filie Filie, that appears as more a toccata-like. Once again, thank you for listening and enjoy.